Hello, boys and girls who are interested in the whole Star Wars loot crate thing. Right, I'm not too sure like what's being said by pretty much every single YouTuber out there is 100% right. Like they don't even know what the fuck they're talking about, I don't think, because they really need to like show you guys how this loot thing works. And I don't know about Overwatch. I mean, I played Halo Wars, and you have cards in there. You can buy packs. Is that pay to win? Same with Halo 5. Pretty much every single game I can think of that's got a multiplayer element in it this day and age has it. I have no idea why they're picking on Star Wars. And yes, I have actually played it. I have videos in my YouTube channel. You can go and check them out if you want. Some of them are quite good. Right, let's go and have a look. First of all, I'm going to have to join a group or something. Well, let's go home. Right, here's the crates. Let me just show you what the crates look like. Right, you've got the trooper crate, the starfighter crate, and the hero crate. See, what I think is really good is the hero crate is the cheapest, but yeah, you can buy them online. If you look at where it says Y on the screen, there's that little symbol, that's a diamond, and it's 110, right? And then where it says A to purchase, that's the credit symbol, and that's 220, that's 2,200, yeah. As you can see, if you look onto the top right of the screen, I have 95 crystals that I've earned in the game, and every single credit I have earned in game, and I have been buying the hero crate, the starfighter crate, and the trooper crate, all from in game. Right, how you do this? Right, there is this bit down here that says press X to get more crystals, right? So let's have a look at that. Shittle's coming up at the moment because, to my knowledge, is they've closed that down, right? For now. So let's go and have a look at my collection. This is where you'll see pretty much everything. All right, here's your heroes. I have Darth Vader to unlock. He's at 15,000 credits. And then there's Luke at the same, and then there's Princess Leia Organa, who's 10,000. Right. And now let's go and have a look at someone so I can show you the star card system. Right, let's look at the assault guy. Right. And if we go equip and craft cards, you can see that I've got two green cards. On one purple card. The purple card means basically that's the highest you can get. That's the improved thermal detonator. Right, and here we go. Here's all the cards for him. I've still got quite a lot to unlock. But what you do, as it says there, if you look on that card there, you've got requirements to meet. Firstly, I need to have my soldier at rank 15, he is, and it requires an assault card level of 15, which it is. And to upgrade, you've got to unlock. You see that little where it says upgrade, and there's that little weird trippy circle? Yeah, you've got to get that as well to put onto the card. Or you can get them randomly through a crate, so you can build on the card, or you can randomly get them. The end card is that, like, my thermal detonator has a blast radius of 7, but that's the only one I've got there. And you get like certain specific cards that can do certain specific things. The way the system works is you can buy them, like, you can straight up craft the card. You don't buy them, you craft them. So that's like 40, 40, and so they're all 40 really to craft. And now it's up to you to take your playing style and maximise into this. I'm a good heavy specialist, so hence why I have the improved thermal detonator, which I built up from grinding. I used to have the smart ion grenade, load of bollocks. I also have the slug vanguard, which gives him like a little shotgun. And I also have the scan dart, so I can help my fellow teammates kind of work out where the enemy is. And then different people have different setups. So, out of all these... Who the fuck bounty hunter is that? I have no idea, but that looks kind of cool. Out of all these cards, you can choose the right playing style for your person and then rack up the points to put onto the cards, right? And then if I go over to career, this is the bit where it gets interesting. Right, to get certain cards, like certain guns, certain improvements, you hit these things, the milestones, right? Let me show you my highest one, which is the heroes. I play a lot of heroes versus villains, right? You complete them, and then you get crafting parts. Like, I've got 25 for completing that one, 250 credits for completing that, 15 crystals for that, and so on, and so on. Like, there's certain ones I'm close to, like, when it counts, and there's not even ones I've done, like, heated victory. And these ones kind of give you the bits to build to put onto the card to make that card better, and you do this all through game. So there is an easy option if you want to grind it. Look on the career, right? And then if we go further down, all the way down, there's actually a lot. I mean, this is just heroes, remember? We see that there's certain things like 25 crafting parts, and they're all the same, I think. Yeah, so it goes each character. So say, like, let's go on all the way up to Chewbacca. I've done Chewbacca. He's bloody hilarious. I brought him using the game credits that I grinded for. And then I just went on here and looked at what I needed to do to get certain things to help. So I've done as Chewbacca. That's his crafting, his credit, and his crystals. And each one pretty much gives exactly the same. And then let's go over to the trooper section, right? Like, I can get, if I do 50 assault kills, I can then get the A2 AE and 200 credits. The reward for that is CR2 and 200 credits. I'm not the best at this game, so it's going to take me a little while to unlock this shit, but I'm still going to do it. In fact, it gives me things to actually look forward to. I have got a sentry crate that I had to progress my sentry. Let me rephrase that because I went a bit fucking weird. I had to defeat 50 enemies with the heavy, like, sentry gun. It's like big fucking chain gun, sort of like what George carries on Halo Reach, right? And I had to kill 50 people with it. Everyone gets gifted the sentry crate. You open the crate and it will give you specific stuff for that. You cannot buy the sentry crate. You have to earn it by doing this. And it's the same with, there's other ones, like you can be rewarded guns, like I've got there, the DC-15 LE, and their snipers and everything. So a lot of these, like the snipers, which are going to be that are going to literally dominate the game because of the campers and the amount of people that normally use snipers, just for the easy pick off of people who don't really know the map. You've got 50 specialist kills, 200 and 500, and you get rewarded for every milestone you hit using that class. It isn't that hard to understand, really. And yeah, it goes on and on and on. You want all these guns, as you can see. They're all under the career, as you can see. And each single one, fuck, look at that. Night vision for the CE-44C. You unlock this night vision, which is really good on some maps, I imagine. You unlock it by beating 150 enemies with the SE-44C on any multiplayer map. And that's a specific gun. The guy who owns that, let's have a look. That would be the officer. See it in his hand? Right, here we go. There's the Blurg. There's the SE-44C. And if I wanted to get the SE-44C, I've got to kill 500 officers with that guy. It's not actually that hard at all to do. And you get a specific loadout of guns that suit to your player choice. And you get these by doing other milestones. So there's a progression system, right? And then you got emotes, like all these. There's a ton of emotes, pretty much. Victory poses as well. You can get all of that in the random crate that you can either grind for, or if you're stupid, you can spend money on it. As you can see, my officer has a variation of cards, right? So you got my improved blaster turret, which is basically it does a little bit more damage than the other one. I built that card by using build on improved battle command. Yeah, okay, some of these drop in crates, but you've got probably as much chance of using the in-game credit system and getting these as you do anything else, because you will often or not, I've had it quite a few times, get duplicates, and that gives you extra credits, right? But with all that in mind, that is purely how the mechanics of the loot box system works, right? You buy something, you can randomly get these cards, but they're so fucking hard because they go up, and the more rarer the card, the harder it is to get. I've got a loot crate opening one, and you get them in different variations. Purple is the rarest. You're probably never gonna ever find a purple card, just drop out of a loot box. You have to build. The closest I've ever got to having a high card drop out of a random loot crate box that I've bought with in-game currency and with my crystals is you get the green, which is roughly about just over common, and then rare is what you have to build using the crafting parts. So it's very hard to get things like the improved battle command, which literally helps, but you've got to have the playing style to actually make that card a friend of yours and not so much just filling up your fucking thing because it's there. And you've got to remember, it's a first-person shooter game. It doesn't matter generally on how good the card is. What actually matters on are you in the right place with the right tool for the right job you're looking at. Because you can have all purple cards and I'll still come along and kill you with my assault guy who's only got two greens and a purple. Because I utilise the scan dart to its best ability and the improved thermal detonator to the best of its ability. And if I'm in close quarters, I then pull out my slug vanguard. You've really got to know a strategy for each one of these. You just can't go in and, oh, I'm going to chuck a grenade and then I'm going to scan the area and then I'm going to run in with my shotgun, because someone could be sitting high up somewhere. Sniper, a few bullets in the head, you're gone. Like any other first person shooter game. Anyway, guys, let me know what you think to what I've shown you. Basically, is that basically how the other people are saying it? Do you agree with the whole loot box thing in general? Do you think Star Wars is to blame? Do you think EA is to blame? I mean, Star Wars isn't to blame. But EA, are they to blame? Or is every other company that peddles loot crates to blame? Also, is what do you think of the current state of multiplayer games? Do you think that the tirade in the multitude of games out there that are multiplayer with pay-to-win elements to them? I mean, even Grand Theft Auto has that, because you can buy jets and stuff. Instead of going out and earning the money, you can just pump money into the game. Boom, you got all this shit, you know? Every game, to my knowledge, has a pay-to-win thing. I just think, at the end of the day, if someone wants to pump a lot of money into the game and get bored of it quicker than what I will through persevering and grinding and getting this gear, go ahead. That'll probably bounce on to Call of Duty or whatever the next big FPS thing is to come out. And they'll forget this ever existed, leaving the true Star Wars fans who love this game playing it. So yeah, again guys, let me know in the comments what you think. And of the whole loot crate thing, and yeah, if you like this sort of video, I will do more, like, going into the guts of the multiplayer loot crate thing as good as I can. This is the first one I've ever done. Normally I just shit out montages because that's what I do. But it's really bugging me that people are hitting Star Wars, something that I've loved since a child. I'm now 30. So yeah. Anyway guys, I'll let you get on with whatever it is you got to do. I've took up about 20 minutes of your time nearly now. So yeah, okay. Thank you, and may the Force be with you in the nature of the video I'm making. Alright. See you later. Bye.